Hi folks, Glyn here. Welcome to episode 64 of this weekly podcast. Well, I say weekly. I've had just 2 or 3 weeks off because I've been heavily involved in the writing of the book and I'm almost finished now. So I thought I'd very quickly dive in with a very, very short tutorial for you. And it's actually something that's going to be included in the book. Now, the technique involves this picture of these rhinos here, where I eventually cut the one out on the left and created this image here, which is a composite where the background's been made up of maybe 5 or 6 different pictures. The rhino's been added in, the dust, the smoke, the birds and all this kind of stuff. So I'll take you through the whole process of that. But while I've been writing, I thought one thing that would be really good to show you very quickly is how we can blend the rhino into the ground so it actually looks like he's stood there. And then I'll show you how we can create some smoke very, very easily using a brush within Photoshop. So if we just go back to the stage where the picture is at this point here, where we've had the original background and we've built up the new background, adding in all these elements in, we've done a cutout of the rhino and then added in the shadow. Now, but when we look and zoom in, we can see that his hooves here, they kind of look like they're floating above the actual surface. So we've got to try and make it look as if he's actually stood on that surface. And we're going to kind of blend the ground in around his feet. Now, a while back, episode 35, I think it was, this one just here, it's called 3 Top Tips for Cutouts and Compositing. In that video on this weekly show, that's where I show you how you can actually make it look as if an object or an animal or a person or whatever is stood within grass, because there's a brush number 1, 3, 4 we can use in Photoshop to do that. So have a look at that video. But this one, because the rhino isn't quite stood on the grass and he's not on a perfectly flat surface, we do need to blend this kind of soil and earth around his feet. And this is really, really simple to do. The technique is fairly similar to the one in that earlier video. So what we're going to do is we're going to click on the layer at the bottom that contains the original field. I'm going to get my lasso tool and make a very, very rough selection of the area around his feet. Then I'm going to press Command or Control J so that that area there that I made a selection of is put onto its own layer like this, you can see. Then I'm going to go to the Layers panel, click and drag that new layer now so that it is above the rhino and it kind of hides his feet. Now, obviously, we don't want to see all of it. We only want to reveal parts of it. So what I'm going to do is hold down my Alt or my Option key and then click on the layer mask icon at the bottom of the Layers panel. And you'll see that's added a black layer mask. So what I want to do is reveal parts of it. So I'm going to get a brush. I've got a white foreground color, but now rather than using the normal blend mode, you can see here we've got the blend modes for the brush. I'm going to use the dissolve blend mode. So now when I zoom in, and all I'm going to do is I've brought my brush size right down. I'm just going to paint around the area where his hooves are actually supposed to be touching the surface. And as I do this with this white foreground color, you may see it on your screen that it's kind of painting in this almost like a spray can spattering kind of effect. I'll just come over to these other ones here, like this, and on this hoof just here as well. Now, I don't know if you can see it when I zoom in, you've got this kind of like spattering going on, but if I just hold down my Alt or Option key, click on the layer mask, you'll be able to clearly see now what that brush has actually done while it's in the dissolve blend mode. So now let's go back to the picture. All we need to do now then is go to Filter, Blur and Gaussian blur, and all I'm going to add in is a 1 pixel radius of blur onto that layer mask. And you can see now in the world's smallest dialog box, this property preview here, if I put my cursor in, that's before, that's after, before, after. So you can see it blurs that kind of spattering effect, and the result of that is it makes it look as if the hooves now are pretty much within that kind of surface. So it really does add to the realism, makes it look like he stood there. And if I turn that on and off, you can see the effect that's having. So that's a technique that I use when I'm actually doing a composite where the person, the object or the animal, whatever it is on a surface that's uneven, not like a flat tarmac or concrete surface, and also when it's not within grass. This works really, really well. So that's the first thing I'm going to show you. The second thing I'll show you now is how you can create a smoke brush with everything that you've got already built into Photoshop. All right, so now then I want to show you how you can use what you've already got in Photoshop to make a smoke or a dust effect kind of brush. Now, there's plenty of places you can download smoke effect brushes. You can go to somewhere like deviantart.com is the perfect example, but there's nothing like kind of making use of what you've already got within Photoshop. And one of the things I always try to get people to play around with more is the brushes panel. There's so many different things that you can do within there. So first of all, let's just create a new document, because I want to show you what we're going to do. So I'm going to put this just something really simple, like 1,000 by 1,000. I'm just make it 240. And I'm just going to fill this with gray so that you can see what I'm doing. Now, we're then going to go to the brush preset picker. Now, within here, we've got one, number 45. You can just see it. This one just here. We're going to use that one as the starting point to making our dust. So we click on that. Then I'm going to go to the brush panel. And this is where we can start to make all these changes. Now, at the bottom, you've got this little preview area here. And you'll see in real time, when you make all the changes using these different options, you'll see what the brush is going to be like just in this little bottom bit. But if I just go to brush tip shape, and if I do nothing but just increase the spacing, you can see that it already starts to look a little bit like dust or smoke. Originally, it looked like that, which doesn't look all that appealing, but we start to space it out and you can see that it already then starts to look like dust. That's a pretty good starting point for us. So now let's go to shape dynamics. Now, we don't want the size of every single brush stroke we paint down to be exactly the same. We need to be completely random. So to do that, we're going to take the size jitter and take it all the way to 100%. We also want the angle of it to be different every single brush stroke we put down. So we take the angle jitter and take that all the way up to 100%. Now, color dynamics, this isn't one that I've covered before, but this is gonna be really handy, because what we want, every time we start to paint down the dust, we want the dust to kind of look like the colors that would come from the soil, rather than just being one single color. So just a couple of colors would make it look a bit more realistic. So to do that, I'm gonna take this little top slider here, foreground, background jitter, and I'm gonna take it all the way across to around about 50%. So that each brush stroke is going to vary between the foreground and the background. And I'll put a little tick in this little apply per tip checkbox at the top there. Finally, I'll click on transfer, opacity jitter as well. And now you can see, when you look in this little preview area down here, you can see what we're actually getting. In fact, I might just close down the spacing just a touch. Something like that. So now you can see it's starting to look like smoke. But what does it look like when we paint it down this area here? Well, I'll just increase the size of the brush. And you can see now, as I'm painting this, you can see that it does actually look like dust or smoke or whatever. And the great thing is, it's not just using one of the colors. It's not just using the foreground. You can see that there's areas that are in there that are white as well. So it's making a good mixture of the two. So here's how we can now use it on our rhino picture. Well, the first thing I'll do then, I'll add a blank layer and I'm going to call this back. And the reason I'm calling it back is because I'm going to drag it now so it is underneath the rhino cutout and it will appear further back in the picture, just like it would do in real life. Whenever we add smoke, debris, dust, rain, snow, you name it, we always want to create depth. So that's why I'm first of all putting some behind the rhino. So what we'll do now then, I'm going to click on the foreground color to bring up the color picker, and I'm going to sample just an area of the ground right by his hooves. And when I click on that, you can see that it gets added into the new section just here. So now when I click OK, you can see over in the left-hand side of the toolbar, my colors are going to go from the color I've just sampled to white. And I like to use white because it does stand out just a little bit more. All right, so get my brush. The opacity at the top of the screen here, you can just see, is at 50%. And all I'm going to start to do is just start to add a few brush strokes around the actual rhino's hooves. I keep trying to say feet, around his hooves, so it looks as if he's kicking up dust as he's walking. So something like this is fine. A little bit to the front and a little bit tailing off into the sky. Now, that might be a little bit too strong, but we can lower the opacity of that layer now just to bring it down to somewhere like that. I'll then add another layer, and I'm going to call this one front, and I'll drag this one so now it's on top of the rhino so that it appears closer to us as we're looking at the picture. Same thing again. I'll then just start adding in some brush strokes around his hooves, nice and big, vary the size of them again, just paint it in so it looks as if he's kind of walking and kicking up the dust. And again, because it's on its own layer, we can use the opacity just to bring that down and start playing around with it. Now, I've done this really quickly, but you can experiment. But you see that in the actual finished picture here, if I just bring that across, you can see the effect that you can get there. So it does look like smoke and dust, and it kind of gives the impression the ground is really soft and is kicking up all the dust from the ground surface there. But you could use this exact same brush for doing smoke. You could even use it for adding like fire by actually changing the color of the smoke as well, using something like a hue and saturation adjustment layer. But hey, that's more for later, more for other tutorials. Just wanted to dive in with two very, very quick techniques for you. Hope you like it. Make sure if you haven't already that you subscribe to the channel. It's all free. You just get to know when there's new videos, and I'll see you next time.